Thank you very much. Good evening. Welcome to the Federal Way Performing Arts Center and this performance featuring the Glenn Miller Orchestra. My name is Eric Stabnow, and I'm from Rochester, New York. I'm the orchestra's music director, and I'll also be your host this evening. And I must say, after a global pandemic and a power outage last week, it certainly feels good to be here performing for you all in Federal Way. Now, we have a program that's going to include a lot of great music, of course, all of Glenn Miller's biggest hits, a few of his lesser-known songs as well, and some additional music from the big band era that's just slightly outside of Glenn Miller's library. And I'm certain that many of you will have recognized our opening song and our theme song, Moonlight Serenade, and that was composed and arranged by Glenn Miller himself and recorded and released by the orchestra in 1939. That was followed by an up-tempo number and a really fun one called Caribbean Clipper. And we finished that opening set with a big hit for the band, of course, Pennsylvania 65,000. And if you know the story behind that song, it gets its title from the phone number to the Hotel Pennsylvania in New York City. That was an important location for Glenn and the band, as they had a regular engagement there at the Cafe Rouge. That was a restaurant and ballroom where they regularly performed for dancers and also recorded radio broadcasts. And we'll be certain to include a bit of history about Glenn's band and about the music as we continue. But before we continue with more great music, I do want to take a chance to introduce some of these folks on stage that you've heard so far, because as you can already can tell, this is a fantastic group of musicians, and these folks come to us from all across the country. Now, the sound of the Glenn Miller Orchestra is characterized by the sound of the reed section led by the clarinet. We call that, fittingly, the Glenn Miller Reed Sound. And you heard that on Moonlight Serenade, and you'll hear it throughout the performance. And we have a fantastic lead clarinetist and lead alto saxophonist. And he comes to us from Chicago, Illinois. How about it for Kevin Sheehan? And you'll certainly hear a number of great solos throughout this performance. This kind of big band music lends itself to a lot of great improvised solos. So you should know that when folks come up here, they are improvising, meaning what you hear is made up right on the spot, and we certainly have the players to do that. You heard a couple of great trumpet solos, one by a gentleman from New Smyrna Beach, Florida. That's Joe Young. And you heard a Caribbean Clipper, a trumpet player from Chicago, Illinois, Chris Stein. And on the tenor saxophone, he's from Cleveland, Ohio. That's John Orsini. Now, of course, the Glenn Miller songbook has a lot of great instrumentals and a lot of great vocals as well, and we're going to continue with another vocal. And this one was recorded by Glenn and his orchestra, featuring his singer at the time, a gentleman named Ray, I believe. But this song was also covered and recorded by a number of different artists in different genres. This one's called When the Swallows Come Back to Capistrano.
Thank you.
Big instrumental hit for the band, and that comes from the year 1939. That was the second year that the band was in existence, of course, formed in March of 1938. And that song, Little Brown Jug, that comes from the 1800s. That predates Glenn Miller and his orchestra, but the version that we played was arranged by a talented gentleman named Bill Finnegan. And he was what you might think of as one of Glenn's staff writers and arrangers. So you'll probably hear that name come up several times this evening. And of course, you heard a few more great solos on that one. Once again, on trumpet, Chris Stein. Our other tenor saxophonist over there is from West Palm Beach, Florida. That's Justin Williams. And you heard our lead trombonist. He's from Anchorage, Alaska. How about from George Ryan? Well, up next is another beautiful vocal ballad, and for that we're going to invite a talented singer to the stage. Her name is Jenny Swoish, and she's from Nashville, Tennessee. And this song comes from the 1950s era of the band. There's a lot of history to the Glenn Miller Orchestra. Yes, they were continued touring during the 1950s under the direction of a leader named Ray McKinney, who was a phenomenal drummer. And once again, as I mentioned, a beautiful vocal arrangement. This one is called Just Imagine.
Dearly. going on in the trumpet.
And how about it once again for Jenny Swoich? And Jenny will be back a bit later to sing a few more songs on her own and to sing a few with our vocal group, which we call the Moonlight Serenaders. Now that last one that she just performed, You've Got Me This Way, that comes from the original band when Glenn stood in front of his orchestra, and that was performed by a gal named Marion Hutton. She was known for doing a lot of what you might call novelty tunes, which are kind of silly, lighthearted pieces, and I think that one certainly fits the bill. Now, Glenn worked with a lot of great musicians, of course. I mentioned Marion Hutton, I mentioned Ray Everly, who are two singers, and we'll continue introducing folks or giving some history about these folks from the original band. But of course, Glenn Miller, in addition to being a talented band leader, writer, and arranger, he was also a great trombonist. And as you folks can already tell, we have a great trombone section over here. Yes, thank you. So you've heard a bit from the reed section, the Glenn Miller reed sound, and we're going to kick off this next tune with the trombone section. And you'll notice that these folks have some different mutes on their stands. In fact, even those derby hat mutes, yes, that is a mute. But on this next song in particular, you're going to have a chance to hear the sound of the toilet plunger mute. Because this is Tuxedo Junction. Now, could you hear the trumpets okay on that one? That's Erskine Hawkins' Tuxedo Junction. You heard a couple more great solos on the piano. A gentleman from Westfield, New Jersey. That's Gil Chapman. Once again on the trumpet, Chris Stein. And from New York City on the trumpet, that's Mason Miller. And of course, Tuxedo Junction is nothing without the trombone section. Now I've got to introduce these folks to you from your left to right. That's Dave Ashley, George Reiner, Dan Gable, and James Borowski. How about for you? Now, Erskine Hawkins, who composed Tuxedo Junction, he was a band leader and a contemporary of Glenn Miller. And that song, of course, was a big hit, Glenn Miller's arrangement of Tuxedo Junction, but it's a pretty simple song. In fact, it's what we might call a riff-based tune, where you take a very simple melody, and if you hear it one time through, you can sing it. There you go. So that's the saxophone melody. You toss in the trombone plunger mute, and voila, you have a big hit from the 1940s. Simple as that. So we thought we'd do something a little bit different today, and we're going to compose a song right here on the spot, a riff-based song, and kind of show you what that process might be like. So with the assistance of our tenor players here in our rhythm section, we are going to make up this song right now. We haven't rehearsed this. We have never played this before. And I'm going to kind of tell you the process, and then we're going to cross our fingers and hope that it actually works the way I tell you. So, we're going to play 12-bar blues, and if you're a musician, that's kind of a song or a song form that we all know. All jazz musicians, swing musicians will recognize that. So we're going to start with the 12-bar blues. We're going to have Gil Chapman play two choruses up front to kind of introduce the song and set the tempo. And then I'm going to invite John Orsini and Justin Williams up here, and we're going to have a tenor triplets battle, if you will. And I'm going to make up a melody just by myself. These guys, they don't know it. I'm going to make it up right here in front of you. And then they're going to join me, we're going to play it in unison. They're going to join me, we're going to play it in harmony. Then we're going to go around, we're all going to solo, we're going to solo together. We're going to feature our bass player on a solo, our drummer on a solo. We're going to play the melody out. Gil Chapman's going to give us a little Count Basie style ending. We're going to hit the last chord. Bada bing, bada boom, you got a number one hit on your hands. How's that sound? Okay. Here goes nothing.
Everybody.
our seniors, Justin Williams on the petty sax, Bill Jackson on the piano, from Washington, D.C., Charlie Hamel on the bass, and from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Dean Schweiger on the drums. So there you go. Now you can compose a song all of your own. I just think we're missing one thing. Next time we're going to get the plunge on you too on that one. What do you think? Alright, so after that we're going to slow things down a little bit and we're going to do a ballad. And now Glenn frequently pulled songs from other musicians' libraries. For example, Tuxedo Junction was composed by that gentleman and band leader Erskine Hawkins. And this next one comes from the Duke Ellington songbook. But of course, as you'll find, a lot of these tunes that come from other bands, of course, Glenn Miller had his own arrangement. And this one's called In a Sentimental Mood.
Thank you.
It's a beautiful arrangement that featured a pair of beautiful trumpet solos there on the muted trumpet, once again, Chris Stein. And you also heard our lead trumpet player from Deland, Florida. That's Ashley Hall. Well, we've got just a couple more songs here, two more, before we take a short 20-minute intermission. And at that time, a few of our trumpet players, Chris Stein and Joe Young, are going to make their way out of the auditorium to the lobby area, and they'll have a few items from the band available for sale, and there's some CDs there. There's a live album, and that's a format a lot like what you're hearing tonight. So it includes, of course, all of Glenn Miller's big hits and some of those fun, lesser-known songs as well. And there's also two studio albums that have been released in the last several years that include even more of that music. So if you have any questions about that or you want to take a piece of the band home with you tonight, be sure to ask those folks what they have there at the sales table. And these next two songs are undoubtedly some of the big hits for Glenn Miller and his orchestra. And this next one was a big hit, especially during World War II, not just for this band, but for a number of other artists at that time. But Glenn Miller's version features his vocal group, which is called the Modern Airs, and I mentioned we have our own vocal group called, fittingly, the Moonlight Serenades. And for that, we're going to invite Jenny Swoich back to the stage and also bring a few gentlemen from the band up to these microphones to sing backup harmonies. Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. Think of your favorite swing band from the 1930s and 40s. This should be an easy one. And no, don't say the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra. Think of your favorite swing band. Now think of your favorite song from that band. We'll see if you can play it next. We'll see you all in about 20 minutes.